just discovered that the video actually had stopped recording, so I'm restarting it now. I'm on the Ashton Canal, on one of the locks. I don't know how much I've recorded before now, but it has restarted, unfortunately. So, that's the building with the interesting roof shape I mentioned earlier. That's the lockkeeper's house, I think, lockkeeper's cottage. And here we're looking over towards the chips. The building on the right is probably an old mill, I think, or originally an old mill. There's nothing left apart from the lower wall to it. So the lock was rebuilt in 1997. It says so there on the lock by somewhere firm in Northwich. Just discovered it wasn't recording as well. Well, it recorded as far as the lifting bridge. You know the lifting bridge just around the corner there? I just thought I'd record it as the mill that's been restored around the other side, Stubbs Mill. I thought I'd record that as it is now.
Okay, yeah.
You can't see it from here though.
The chips are
in the way.
Yeah.
So, get it at this stage before it's actually been worked on at all. Well, apart from knocking the roof off and clearing out the inside.
Yeah.
It's
are you a bit of a historian then, are you?
I've had an interest in the dispensary for quite a while now.
Put
some money towards that.
Well, they got some off the did they get some off the lottery?
They did, yes. The match funding came through, yes.
Yeah.
Some local businessman put in £28,000 at the end and paid it all off, which is very good of him, whoever
it is. I've seen it, was on television, wasn't it?
Yeah,
it was, the restoration one.
Yeah.
So what are they turning that into? Is it going to be like a community place?
It's going to be community on the ground floor, as far as I'm aware. And they're going to be arts and all sorts of other stuff on the floors above.
About time to save some decent groups. Buildings instead of knocking it down, putting all that crap up,
isn't it? Well, I don't know, the chips has got a kind of character to itself, I suppose.
It has now, but you're watching 10 years' time when it's all bits of
falling off. Apparently it leaks as well, unfortunately.
You're watching 10 years' time when bits are falling off, if you look at it.
What was this to the right? Was that a mill as well?
It was a mill, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, it was a mill.
And that's one just to the... Just there would be the lockkeeper's cottage.
Well, they're beautiful then.
Yeah.
Beautiful cottages.
That's been restored as well, obviously.
Yeah, absolutely gorgeous then.
I like the building behind it, the one with the jagged roof. Oh, that's a nice one.
See the one just beyond, the one beyond that building where they put the new flats up, that was stopped work that, because everything was substandard, brought in from Japan. No fireproofing, no nothing, that's why it was all stopped and the company who owned it went into liquidation.
Well, I'm not surprised. I think you see that fire in Dubai the other week in the building was appropriately called the Torch.
Yeah.
Oh, the cladding was flammable, for Christ's sake.
Yeah, a lot of these things are. I mean, it's like Mr. Smith, look when that went up in Warrington last week.
Yeah, cladding should definitely be fireproof.
Of course, well, you'd think it would be, wouldn't you?
I mean, I wonder about what they're putting on the flats on the A664 on the way into Middleton from Manchester, whether they're okay or not.
On the A664?
You know, the Rochdale Road, it's called?
Yeah.
On the left-hand side, just past the railway bridge.
Right, yeah.
Where it was closed a few months ago.
Yeah, yeah.
because
I don't know what they've done with
the reason I'm saying that is because when they put them on, there's a kind of gap between the outside and the building, which is like a chimney.
Right.
So if a fire starts low down and it's not fireproof, whoosh, up it goes.
Yeah, we see, because we work in the industry, we see some sites and it peggles the leaf, some of the stuff you see.
Yeah.
And you think people paid a lot of money for it.
You're the underground department, I'm saying.
Yeah, we're on there from the start, and then we normally end up on there when it's finished to do the pulse survey, but we see some sites, and you just think, someone paid £500,000 for that apartment, and you've seen what went into it.
Well, if you don't get the drains right, nothing works properly.
Well, that's it. Well,
fundamental.
There's a lot in town now that they have a lot of problems with, where we've done the surveys and all that, they put the drainage in, they made massive mistakes, and people are getting the apartments flooded with sewage.
Yeah. That's no fun at all.
No, you like there, not when you spent £500,000 on mum.
Alright, cheerio, have a good day. That was a drain engineer we're talking to there. Right, so let's get back here while the battery's still running. I don't know how old the ship's building is, but he's probably right about the finishing. I mean, you've got to really know how sound this stuff is. Oh, there's the geese, or two of them. One on the opposite side of the fence. I'll try not to disturb it. You can see it there. Two more over by the lock gate. Getting up now. Beware, there's a goose just ahead of you. Right, here we are back at the lifting bridge. Seen this thing open up?
No, no.
Must have electric motors in the uprights, I think. Ah, we've got just noticed that wooden buffers all the way around the edge of the stonework. To protect it. There's an absolute flotilla of narrowboats over the other side. Here, open this bridge up and visit his friends in the chips. Looks like this basin was actually bigger, because the left-hand side is steel piles, and they're definitely not original. It's a good design. Thank you. tower on the other side. Sides of it. People who travel on the canals and live on these narrow boats. In fact, there's one at the end that's not a narrow boat at all. Now that's a different animal altogether. Captain Jack, here it is. Now that definitely would not fit through the locks. It wouldn't fit through the locks in the canal we've just been on anyway, because it's too wide by a long stretch. Cottonfield. Notice the steel allowed to rust. That's a theme throughout the area. There's obviously some fish in here as well. fish are there in here? Presumably a decent size too, I imagine.
Yeah, they can be. Old pike as well, sorry.
Oh, there will be, yeah. They always get in, yeah.
Yeah, pike. I've only caught two so far.
Not today or any day?
All days are different.
Yeah.
The other day I only caught one. And my friend over there caught four. And when we came last week, I ended up catching nine.
Wow.
So it depends. But this time last year, we used to catch like 20, 21 a day.
So why have the numbers dropped then?
I don't know.
I wonder if some people have been taking them away and eating them.
I heard that the Polish do that, don't
they? Yeah, that's what I'm thinking, yeah. Yeah. Because they don't recognise that it's for a sport and it's stocked by the actual anglers themselves as well.
Yeah, you have to put them back. Yeah. Obviously, you've got to have a licence as well, which I've obviously
indeed,
got.
Indeed, yeah.
Because obviously you get done.
Is there any plant life in here for the fish to feed off, or do they just...
No, I've only been fishing since last year.
Right.
I just put the rod in the water, put the maggot on and catch fish.
Right. Nice and peaceful anyway.
Yeah, it is peaceful on common travel. I live near Warrington.
Alright.
So I've just travelled all the way. Try and come here once a week.
Well, I'll let you enjoy your day. Dry at the moment, or it's full of pondweed. But if that's deliberate, it must be, I suppose. This obviously was part of the canal originally. This is a mile from the centre of Manchester. Stone Island there with pines on it. More pines over there. And old mills restored. Afternoon. See over there new flats and new buildings, different designs, more going up in the distance as well. The project was held back by the problems in 2008. Things kind of ground to a halt, but it should be finishing off now. There's work going on all around us here, all the way around us. I'm a bit puzzled about the Captain Jack, as it's too big to get through the locks. I have a suspicion it's been purpose-built and launched here. Unless there's a wide canal leading in somewhere.